This is my 045 Duramax GMC. Actually, it's probably a 5 because that's when they made the transition from the 4s to the 5s, from the LB7 engines to the Lily LY. And there was a change in that from the LB7 in the fact that the LB7 had the injectors inside the valve covers and it had a wastegate. Then GM went ahead and upgraded the engine, put the injectors outside of the valve covers, and then added, of course, the emissions that California. So this one actually had the emissions on it. But saying that, anyway, we're going on a trip and I decided to change all the fluids of the differential transfer, front and rear differential. And so that's what my process. It's great having this lift for us old guys. No more getting underneath there and then having to have your sons pull you back out. So I'm going to go in here. I'm going to change the front diff, the transfer case, the rear axle. The transmission was done probably about 15, maybe 20,000 miles ago. We looked at the fluid. I dropped a little bit. It looks good. So I'm going to just leave it. It smells great. Decent color. And so I'm going to get that. I'll go ahead and I've got these shocks, front shocks. The rubber's gone from the bottom of the mounting. Could replace those mounting, but I think I'm just going to go ahead and put new shocks on it. Probably the shocks probably have 40,000 miles on them, so they probably just as well. So I'm going to put new front shocks on it and just kind of look it over so that this truck is worthy to head on this trip we're going to be taking next week. So anyway, that's what I'm going to do. Just go ahead and change the oils. This is great. We've got this oil collector. It's great. You can raise it up, catch the body of oil that's coming out, and then eventually you can take this and put it in our used oil tank. So anyway, it takes about 2 gallons, 8 quarts to fill, and I'm putting synthetic in to fill the bodies. So I'll get that accomplished and away we'll go. Yeah, kind of a neat trick for filling these tight inlets for the differentials, especially the front and the transfer case. Rear axle isn't so bad, but you know, trying to get these little squirt bottles in there, what you can do is put a hose here, put a hose clamp on, just cut it, of course, open it up, and then go ahead and when you get it up there, poke a hole in it and use air chuck and just slowly push air in it. And with this tipped up like this level, it will completely empty out the bottles into the chambers. But two in the front, two in the transfer case. So they took about a gallon to fill those and it really went easy. Really not much mess. And of course the rear, you have here a very easy plug to go ahead and access it. You could pretty much squirt it in here, but I just use the same thing, suck a hose in there, squirted 4 bottles. It just started coming out, so I think we're good to go. So I'm just looking at a few more things underneath here, and it looks like everything's tight. No defects except for those shocks that I'm going to tackle. And I think it needs a wash job. It's got the winter paint on it right now. I need to take some of that off. It'll probably get recoated with winter paint, but we'll get it cleaned up. It's been a great truck. Love the Duramax. I love the way the power in it, and I've done quite a bit of towing with a fifth wheel with it. It does a great job. Really appreciate it. And I just keep this old truck, just keeps going. So probably doesn't have as many miles as a lot of other Duramaxes because it's not a daily driver, but it's got a lot of life left. So keep it up and it'll serve me well. Yeah, also I'm gonna change the engine oil on this. It's time to change it. And I put one of these on a long time ago, one of these quick valves that you just push over, flip up, and then push over. And it sure makes it nice as far as draining the oil on this engine. So if you get one of these, it saves a lot of trying to get underneath there, especially if you don't have a lift. And so this, that makes it well. One thing about it nice is look where they have the oil filter. Isn't that nice? Yeah, right handy. Sometimes engines, you get tucked away in there. Of course, with a lift, things are a lot easier for us old guys. Took the old shocks off, got the new one sliced up there, slid up there, not sliced, otherwise I gotta go back to the store. But anyway, got the shock slid up there, put the two washers in. I'm now tightening, holding the shaft on the top, tightening this down till this rubber donut is swelled out past the washer, and that should be snug enough. And then do the other side and we're good to go. The shock itself might not have been wore completely out, but what happened was the rubber bushing in here came loose and evidently rubbed, bounced back and forth, cut whatever, and it completely cut it out and fell out. So this centerpiece here was jumping up and down on the bolt. So new shocks, time to replace them. They're easy to do on this vehicle and really not much money. So I'm excited to see this new shock on the road. And because I had a little clanking and I thought that was kind of unusual. Well, this is the clank. So easy repair.
I've got the case back in here. We have the seals, the bushings for that front hub. Hopefully I have everything I need, and hopefully there's no surprises. I did not get bearings for the front planetaries, and I did not get universal joints. So if I pull it apart and I find out they're bad, then I'll have to go another direction. But saying that, we need to take this wheel off. I gotta take the hub off and I gotta start inspecting things. And if everything looks good, put the seals, put the bushings, and put it all back together, and tractor's good to go. That's the idea. Right here, I believe that is our culprit right there, this bushing. It went out, and I think this is the main seal that went out, and I got some other seals here too, so let's go ahead and tackle that.
It's on there.
This one hot? Okay. So he's trying to take these off the top and bottom of this hub here. The top one came out, the bottom one is really in there.
Yeah, I'm kind of messing it up a little bit. Okay, engineers, when you make something that goes in one way, can you please just factor in putting a threaded bolt right here? So you can take bolts, stick one right here, and slowly tighten, and it'll force it like a hydraulic ram, or basically a press, and press it back out. What I'm dealing with right now is I'm trying to put something in here and try to wedge it down, pull it down, and there's nothing to grip on it. Just in the future, if you ever have it.
It'd make life.
Yeah, a little simpler.
Let's try a little bit of motivation. Honda style. Managed with the four-wheeler and the leverage with the big pipe wrench and pipe to spin it 360 degrees inside there. So it's spinning, and every time we do that, we're breaking the rust up that's causing that to bind in there. And he's wedging it with a bunch of punches and chisels, see if he can get it to come down. I mean, it's not much in there. It's only like that long, but it's just a brute. But yeah, we might have to use the four-wheeler some more. We'll see.
Not too bad.
Is this flying shaft? Let's just slide right off.
It should.
So let's take this down. This has got a twist too somehow to get this out. Oh, there you go. It's off. Sometimes things like that just fight you. And I don't know why. They just do. How's that universal? Oh, it's like a CVC.
I would say the universal feels good. They're slopping it because it's moving back and forth with the joints, but they don't feel bad at all. I'm not worried about it. When I was ordering the parts, I looked inside. It wasn't leaking from the seal coming out of the axle housing. We're here, we probably should change it, but I'm not going to since it's not leaking.
Whoa, we've been down this road. You know what's gonna happen.
It's gonna leak.
And everybody's gonna tell you that.
Yeah.
Do we not have the seal?
No, I don't have the seal, but that means you gotta pull the axle shaft off, and then you gotta take a compression ring around the axle, you gotta pop that off, and you gotta do other stuff. I don't want to mess that right now, so
okay, Yeah. You guys heard it.
You heard it.
That's how it is.
I just want to get it fixed.
Go ahead and tell us, though, how frustrated you are that we didn't do that. That's okay.
Farmer style. You can't always have everything you want, right?
But I did order new tie rod ends. These are a little wore out. The other side, too. Checked it. It's loose. So it wasn't bad.
So the culprit, why it was leaking, is this is a U-joint, slides into here, and there's a copper bushing in there, and it's got play and moving back and forth, and the seal right here is what was leaking. That's what I come to conclude or figured out. So I'm gonna replace that. I gotta pull all this apart, inspect everything, the bearings, and put this stuff together, so yeah. This is a planetary on the front of an axle. For those that don't know what it looks like, this is what it looks like. If you're trying to find a way of making a shaft spin from, let's just say 200 RPM to 100 RPM, you have to gear it down some way, basically like a transmission. Well, this is kind of similar to that, but its own way. They call it planetaries. With this shaft spinning, it goes inside, rotates, and as it rotates, it rotates on here too, and it's that's sharp. Here's a piece of metal. Watch out for that sucker right there. Yeah, it stabbed me. Another way to describe it is two gears. You got a small gear and you got a big gear. And if you have a chain on it, the gear reduction is different. Well, instead of using a chain, they use a series of gears running mesh it together with different sizes, and it reduces or increases the speed depending on how you want to do it. There you go. I pulled the axle shaft, or you could say planetary shaft, whatever you want to call it, and took the bushing out of the housing, and this is the bushing that went bad. Here's the new bushing right here. It doesn't have the slop like the other one does. The other one was kind of like an egg. It wasn't all the way around. It kind of wore itself up and down. And so I'll put this in. I've got a new seal right here. The old seal was just, it's weathered. It's just old rubber. Couldn't seal very well. I'll take that, put it back together, put this housing back on the tractor, and then just keep on cleaning up stuff, cleaning up the bearings, put those back on, put some other seals on, and put the wheel back on and get this tractor running. So on D-Boss's video, if you watch how they do the seal, he actually had a really good idea, which I'm gonna copy, is take the original seal, and since I have a lathe, I cut it out so that it will fit over that lip as he describes in the video. Really good video, by the way. And I'm gonna use it to press it in. Now, when you're installing seals, you wanna make sure that you try to install them evenly. You don't want it to be cockeyed because you can warp the seal, and beating on it is not always the right way to do it. Try to push it down evenly. Sometimes in a situation you have to tap on it with a hammer to try to get the seals in if you don't have a press, but try to avoid beating on it. But since I have a press and I have a lathe, I'm gonna press this in. I said I was gonna use this original shaft. I thought it looked good, and to the eye, it looks good. But after installing it, I grabbed it, and you can wiggle it back and forth, as you can tell. That's not really what I wanna have. What happened is, as the oil drained out of it, and it wasn't necessarily us, it was probably the guy that had it before us that ran it dry, because it's always been leaking a little bit since we've had it, and we've just added oil to it. Well, as the round shaft is like this, it wore it enough, and it created kind of like an eggshell, so it's oblong, and that little bit of play, when it's underneath load and running all the time, will take out the back seal, and then it's gonna start wearing on the bushing incorrect, and oil's gonna come out of the back. It's just not worth having that. So I went ahead and got a new shaft, which is right here, and it's a couple hundred bucks, more like $400 and some dollars. I'm not gonna go into that, but I won't have to worry about it being untrue. I'm gonna go ahead and take the old one out, like so, and I'm gonna stick the new one in. Yeah, it's gonna be going really well. Before I put the planetary hub assembly on, I don't know what you want to call it, but that's what I'm going to call it today, and that's the correct term in my vocabulary. I'm going to go ahead and clean up this O-ring right here, put some gasket maker on it, just in case if it doesn't seal very good. I don't have a new O-ring, that's fine though, it just has to seal. And then when you put the outside hub on, there's two set screws, well I shouldn't say, they're an Allen wrench bolt, and take that one off, take the other one off, and make sure you line that up before you put it on, otherwise you're going to have to pull it off and realign it, and that's just unnecessary work. So you just want to keep your eyes out, look at something, okay, it goes on this way, hopefully it does it the right way, and then go from there. But yeah, I'm gonna install that. The next thing I also have is new tie rod bushings. I'm gonna stick one on the other side and this side because these ones are just wore out, and then put the tire back on, and well, I should be good to go. I was gonna change this, but we got the wrong threads. There's a right hand and left hand thread that screws into here. So I'm not gonna touch it right now because I don't have the correct one. I'll have to get it later. I just went ahead and put it back on. We'll run it, it'll still hold together. It's not like completely wore out where it's gonna be a safety hazard, but there is some slop in it. So something that we're gonna have to change out, just not right now. But I'm gonna go ahead and hook up the cylinder and then put the wheel on after I wash out, because it's easier to wash it with it's off. Put that on. I'm gonna put some grease in here and then start the tractor up and bring it outside, and well, I'll be done for a while. Now that I got assistance from a random stranger that randomly showed up, good friend of ours, he helped me put the tire on. We had to move the tractor forward just a little bit because we need to fill that hub with oil. Well, I can't just spin it on the spot unless I lift up the other tire, which I didn't want to do, so we just drove forward. Now that it's level, I'm gonna add oil into it, put the cap back in, and we should be good. I'm gonna go ahead and hook the 3-point up to that grader blade and a little bit. It's warm enough, the ground's thawed out some, smooth out some ruts. Well, so far the 3-point works really good. It steers, it runs, and I'm gonna park this thing and shut it off. Well, that's nice to know. The 3-point works really well, and it runs really good. Of course, we knew that. And just to take a look over here, any surprises? Yeah, looks good, no leaks so far. Saying all that, the tractor's good to go. I'll just park it right there until we need it. If you enjoyed what you saw, could you please click that like and subscribe button, because that helps us out so that we can make more videos for you to see and watch and experience. But guys, thank you so much for the time that you've given to just see a little bit of what we do each day. God bless.